Quid pro quo, Joe, he decided to come out of hiding this week. It was an unmitigated disaster. Small sample.
Excuse me. You know, you're supposed to cough into your elbow. I don't know, sir. I learned that actually covering your White House.
Actually, that's true, but fortunately I'm alone in my home, but that's okay. We have to take care of the cure. That will make the problem worse no matter what. Why doesn't he just act like a president? That's a stupid way to say it.
You know, Donald Trump was asked us.
Sorry.
Go ahead.
No, probably best I don't. I just can't figure the guy. It's like watching a yo-yo. I shouldn't have said it that way. It's like watching.
It feels that way. I want to ask.
Our Secretary of State insisted, and this broke the meeting up basically in terms of her influence, that this be called the Wuhan virus.
Oh boy. Good news for Biden? Maybe. No one paid attention. Viewership for his virtual happy hour this week, 2,800 viewers. And just breaking tonight, Biden caught in another lie because it turns out Biden and Obama saw millions in CDC funding cuts, completely undercutting Biden's smears and lies against President Trump, which are saving thousands of lives, of course. Now, Biden was asked about this moments ago. He didn't have a good answer. Take a look.
Should the Obama administration have done more to replenish the supplies in preparation for future outbreaks?
Well, we spent a lot of time. I was not part of it. Our administration spent a lot of time working with the incoming Trump administration, laying out exactly what could happen with a future pandemic.
Oh boy, reaction. Fox News contributors Tammy Bruce, Jason Chaffetz. Tammy, 60.8 million Americans got that virus, hundreds of thousands hospitalized. By the time Obama and Biden themselves declared a national emergency, 1,000 dead Americans. There was 13,000 Americans in a year and tens of thousands that contracted it in the media. We didn't have the death count. We didn't have the contracting counts then. Why is it different now? That was a pandemic. This is a pandemic.
It sure is. And obviously, there's bias. There was protection then. I think what Joe Biden's experiencing now, which is a little surprising, even in that first debate when Kamala Harris went after him, was the fact now that questions are being asked. And mainly because some of the media have a candidate they prefer other than Joe Biden. But what's fascinating too, and why his week was so bad, he was trying to hide, is that there really is no competition for Donald Trump. And the other problem the Democrats have is they have spent over 3 years lying to the American people about the capabilities of Donald Trump. And now that he has daily, unfettered, unfiltered ability speaking to the American people, dealing with a major crisis for all of us, they're finding out how much they've been lied to. That's why his numbers have gone up so considerably. And then, of course, you've got the issue with Joe Biden, is that there's never really been any real leadership. The Democratic Party knows it. They complain that, you know, they're getting blown out by Donald Trump. But the fact of the matter is, look, I've opted to remain in Manhattan. We are reaching the world here through modern new technology, from my apartment. Joe Biden has every capability of reaching people if they were interested, and the Democrats have to worry about a lack of enthusiasm, which is what we've seen with obviously the poor numbers he's been experiencing online.
Again, he got it wrong again. We hold these truths to be self-evident, et cetera, et cetera. Endowed by their creator, endowed by the thing. All right, Jason, I don't care. Put whatever term you want it. This guy is lost in space, and it's a little scary.
Every day that he wakes up and they turn on the cameras is a bad day for Joe Biden. I mean, this person was elected to the United States Senate in 1972. I was barely starting to play soccer then. He's all about yesterday. He has no vision for the future. And I got a beef with you, Sean Hannity, because I had to watch part of that town hall to come in on here and talk about it. And I tell you, it's an embarrassment because he likes to do numbers. Well, there's two things here. And then he starts and he loses count. And then he has to go back to number one. Oh. In one question, he went to number one three times. It's
I love that. This is my favorite moment, though. This is my favorite moment. He's doing the town hall thing, and then all of a sudden he forgets he's on camera, and then it's just like, starts talking, walks off camera. I mean, this is not, Tammy, this is serious now. This is the president of the United States. You need strength, stamina, mental alertness. You need to be sharp.
This is important because the Democrats, it is very hard to believe. And look, the 2020 campaign has essentially been put on hold, right? But in the traditional way, the traditional rallies for Donald Trump have been put on hold. But the Democrats, I think, still are looking for a way to get out of this. And it doesn't mean they have to even have a brokered convention in a classic sense. Someone could step up close to whenever they have their convention, if they're still able to do it, and say, look, he's got, we agree he's got to go. His family wants him to withdraw.
Oh, there's still a problem.
And watch out for someone like Cuomo who thinks that he's the one who can beat Donald Trump. Watch out for that.
Yeah, the guy that did no preparation for any emergency.
Yeah.
All right, thank you both.
Exactly.
When we come back, mob and the media keep contradicting themselves. We want to see Donald Trump until he does really well. Then we've got to stop seeing Donald Trump. We got a new poll. The American mob at its lowest rating ever. We'll share that next.